please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
2 weeks after receiving no response for its Air India expression of interest, the government is now looking at Plan B. So sources say the centre is mulling an idea for an IPO for Air India. Ashpreet Sethi has been tracking all the developments in that Air India stake sale. She joins us with all the details. Ashpreet, how feasible is the IPO idea turning out to be?
Well, it's, for now, what we pick up from sources, in fact, these sources are part of the alternate mechanism of ministers that are looking into Air India. Remember, Areeb, it's the finance minister who's been heading it. Now, of course, what we pick up from sources right now is that after the flop show that had come across for Air India divestment, now there have been suggestions as to how listing can be done of Air India. Now, what we pick up from sources is that the government is trying to go the Hindustan Zinc way. Remember that they had put the shares in the market, and then once they had got a good price, they had sold those shares and by that way sold their stake in Hindustan Zinc as well. Right now, they do have a stake in that company. Like that, they want to go ahead with Air India so that government doesn't lose its control as far as Air India is concerned. Now, this is very absurd at this moment because remember, the government has been saying we want to invite FDI. They even changed the rules as far as getting foreign investment is concerned. But what we pick up right now is that the main suggestion has been that don't give control ownership to any of the foreign entities. So we'll have to wait and see which proposal will be accepted as far as Air India is concerned, because next week is when the group of ministers will be meeting.
Right, Ashpreet, just hang on with us. We're also going to talk to you about the other story that you're tracking, where earlier this year, Road and Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari, in a remarkable bold face, had asserted that there was no need for a policy on electric vehicles. The minister's rationale was that the electric vehicle standards finalized by the Niti Aayog would be used as a final benchmark. But now we are learning that the government may not have pulled the plug on an EV policy just yet. What are you picking up regarding that?
Well, it's absolutely, it seems like the flip-flop is just not ending. First, the government said last year we will go ahead with an EV policy. 2030 is the deadline as far as 100% electrification is concerned, as far as roads are concerned. And then second, Nitin Gadkari made a statement in February saying, no, an EV policy is not required. But now we pick up from top government sources that meetings have been held. Consultations are still on as far as a possible EV policy or an action plan is concerned. Now, what are the suggestions that have come forth as far as past two, three meetings are concerned? First, go ahead and give tax incentives as far as EV is concerned. Give it to the manufacturers or to the people who will be buying. But remember, Finance Ministry had raised an issue earlier. Even now, right now, they have raised an issue and apprehension as to giving out money from their kitty. They're saying, look at non-fiscal incentives as far as the EV policy is concerned. The second important point being here, the discussions are as to how in two, three cities, smart cities, the implementation can be done and later carried forward in other states. But it remains to be seen whether the 2030 deadline will still remain, because the final roadmap is still awaited as far as the holistic EV policy is concerned.
Right, Ashpreet. In fact, that is a good idea, where you use two or three cities as pilots, two or three congested cities. Many thanks for joining us with all the details from there.